There was a time in my life when I was already a Christian, but I was living far away from God's plan for me. I was filling my weekends with a lot of partying and was putting my own enjoyment before everything else. Then, the summer before my grade 11 year, I went to People's Youth Camp. It was after that camp that I began to see things differently. I began to accept the fact that life wasn't just about me. That's when I made the decision to follow God's plan for my life to the best of my ability. He is real.
I don't know for sure when I knew God was real, but He shows me every day that He loves and cares for me. With God, all things are possible. Matthew 19:26. I have been reading my Bible every night since February of 1999. I can't remember for sure if it was when I took a class here at People's, but I do know that it's very good to learn His Word and, more important, to base our actions after Him, showing that we have the faith and trust God wants us to portray to others. He is real.
In grade 7, I started to walk down the wrong road. I made some bad choices and actions to match. The only reason I wasn't stopped is because my mom was busy getting on my older sister's case, leaving me free to climb the ranks of the naughty. Bad became worse. I changed schools and changed attitudes. Slowly, I turned around and began walking back towards God, finding out why I'm here. I did some soul searching, some reevaluation, and 3 years and 1,000 tears later, here I am, and glad of it. He is real.
I wake up a lot at night. I can't get back to sleep, so I get up and go to the couch. I look out the window and think about stuff. I used to get scared and try to find distractions. But I began thinking about God when I was outside. He became very real. It was so peaceful and so amazing that the fear would go away. I would start thinking more about God instead of worrying. Now I just enjoy being with God. He is real.
I had become a Christian 9 years ago, but every once in a while I've had a supernatural experience that has impacted me. A while ago, I was driving along 100th Street here in Grand Prairie in a 1983 Mercury Grand Marquis. I noticed a group of people walking on a sidewalk ahead of me. As I got close to them, my car seemed to move over from the lane beside the sidewalk. I had caught up to them, and then the man stumbled right into the lane that I had been driving in. I would have hit him at full speed. He is real.
There was a time when Christ became very real to me. God was challenging me to forgive someone that had hurt me very deeply. I was just spending some time with God and I was really humbled by what He had actually done for me. He died a brutal death to make a way for me and to offer me forgiveness. It really caused me to think, whoa, if Jesus did that for me, then surely I can offer forgiveness to others. I could let this go and stop selfishly holding on to the pain. He is very real.
I chose Jesus as my Savior and was baptized about 9 years ago. I knew my past sins were going to be forgiven and that I was going to do great things for Jesus. Wrong. You don't do great things for Jesus. Jesus does great things for you. My self-centeredness and almost 40 years of sinful living in a sinful culture took me a long time to adjust to this concept. After 10 years of pruning and growing, I am now becoming the person that Jesus wants me to be. Now He can do great things through me. He is very real.
When my daughter was born, she was 28 weeks along. She was 3 months early, and they had to ship her out to Edmonton. And the first week of her life, she caught a really bad infection, and the doctors didn't think she was going to make it. 2 days later, lo and behold, she came through with flying colors. She was great, and then they realized she had a heart murmur. And the medication that they were giving her for her heart wasn't working. And they figured they would have to go in and do surgery. And the day of the surgery, the doctor came to me and he said, I don't know how to explain it, but her murmur is gone and we don't have to go in and do the surgery. She's gonna get a clean bill of health. And for that, for me, was when I realized that God does work miracles. God is so powerful. He He gave me my child to love and to hold and to care for, and she's getting better every day, and she's over 6 pounds now, and she's just amazing. And for me, that's the greatest gift I think the Lord can give anybody, is their children. And He gave me my daughter.
Time in my life when God became very real to me was about 10 years ago. I was having minor day surgery at the hospital, and things went terribly wrong. The doctor made a small error and hit the basal vagal nerve in my neck, causing me to go into cardiac arrest. Suddenly, panic and chaos was everywhere, including within me. I remember the prayer I prayed that day and the calm that came over the whole situation. God put 4 highly skilled people into that emergency and changed the entire outcome. He is very real.
My brother Roger was killed in 1992. He and my sister Nicole were on the way to Dawson Creek when they met a semi-truck hauling a load of lumber. The trucker did not have his load secured, and when he lost control, the wood came off and smashed through my brother's car. Roger died a few hours later in the Dawson Hospital, but God spared Nicole's life. This could have been a really dark time for our family, but God graciously held us up and supported us through this time. We pulled together as a family through God's love, comforting us and helping us. Roger's short life impacted so many people. People still come up to us and comment on how Roger's zeal for life and zest for God has impacted their lives and made them re-examine their own walk with God. I know that Roger would never change what happened if he knew that just one more person would become a Christian and be able to enter God's kingdom. And neither would us as his family.